In their recent press release, the Labour Party purported to respond to the political leader of the UWP, Mr. Alan Chesney, when he stated that the government has been benefiting handsomely from the surplus funds earned as a result of the over 50% decline in world crude oil prices over the last 6 months, while the price at the local pump has remained relatively unchanged. The Prime Minister's office stated that government's revenue does not change and any benefit is absorbed by the petrol retailers. However, according to the UWP, the Petroleum Dealers Association has categorically denied that its members benefit from any such arrangement and stated emphatically that they only receive $1.05 per gallon as prescribed by government through the Distribution and Goods Act of 2006, which regulates their profit margins under this gas pass-through mechanism.
The Labour Party has blurred the lines between the role of the party and the functions of government. When the party responded using the Prime Minister's office and his acting press secretary. In their recent press releases, the Labour Party purported to respond to me when I stated that the government has been benefiting handsomely from the surplus funds earned as a result of the over 50% decline in world crude oil prices over the last 6 months, while the price at the local pump has remained relatively unchanged. The Prime Minister's office stated, and I quote, government's revenue does not change, and any benefit is absorbed by the petrol retailers.
According to Mr. Chesney, at the end of each three-month period when the accounts are reconciled, there is a clear surplus, and more so over the last 6 months. As far as he is concerned, the question must be asked as to why, in this environment, government seeks to benefit from what he describes as a massive surplus at the expense of the citizens and businesses of St. Lucia.
It is clear that this government does not understand that lower gas prices, as in the United States, EC $5.40 a gallon, or St. Kitts $10.75 a gallon, as compared to EC $15.80 in St. Lucia, will provide a major stimulus to our economy and provide urgently needed relief to the well-being of our people. Both in the United States and in St. Kitts, where gas prices have been reduced on a regular basis, we've seen a boost in their economies as a result.
Mr. Chesney says St. Lucia's economy is the only one to contract 3 years in a row. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.